they aren't. And what do? They plot on us. They think of ways to bring you down. And most of the time, you don't even know that they're doing it. They come at you from your blind side. I mean, you don't believe it? You have some people at work who are plotting on you. Don't believe me? Get a promotion. Drive a better car than your coworkers drive. Oh, and don't have a nicer house than your boss has. All right. You'll have people devising schemes against you. Come on, they'll be plotting on you. Right. Young people, there are people plotting on you at school. Yes. Don't believe me? Just carry yourself with some decency and respect. Yes. Make good grades and have some goals in your life. All right. Let your teachers say good things about you. Before you know it, you're going to have people plotting on you. You have family members plotting on you. You see, all of the people in this story are kinfolk. Israel and the Midianites were descendants of Abraham. The Moabites were descendants of Lot, Abraham's nephew. So Israel had their kinfolk plotting on them. We can't think just because someone shares the same last name that we have, or as a part of our bloodline, we can't think that they won't get jealous and plot on us. That's good. That's good. You even have some church folk plotting on you. Don't believe me? Get a position that they want. Be on the program more than they are. You'll find out that you have people plotting on you. But when God speaks for you, nobody can speak against you. People may devise all manner of schemes against you, but rest assured, God won't let it prosper. And that's something to be glad about today. I don't have to see all the attacks that people are coming at me from, because I know that as long as I'm faithful, God will stand in the way. God will block for me. So this king devised this plot against God's people. And in verses 6 and 7 of this chapter, you see how he sent messengers to persuade Balaam to go and curse God's people. So after being tempted by the offers from this king, he finally decides to go against God's command and curse Israel. So in verse 21, it says he saddled up his donkey and went with the princes of Moab. But God had already told him in verse 12 that he was not to go and curse Israel because they were blessed. And whenever we decide to go against the will of God, we might as well get ready, because we're headed for some trouble. So we're told in verse 22 that God's anger was kindled or set ablaze against Balaam because he went with the princes of Moab. Now, God wasn't angry because he went, but he was angry because Balaam intended to go through with his original intentions. I'm reminded of what Proverbs 19 and 21 says, when it says, many are the plans of a person's heart, but it's the Lord's purpose that prevails. You see, we can have our own plans, but it does not matter, because if it's not part of God's purpose, it won't prevail. So while on his way to do this dirty deed, verse 22 tells us that